inspiration for the KVVI came from news that one single KV-2 had held off an entire German tank division for 24 hours. Stalin, inspired from his success, ordered the design of an even greater tank. The project was given to the Kautin-Barkov team, although the designer insisted that three turrets would make the tank too long and in turn structurally unstable with a giant turning radius. Stalin supposedly responded by saying, "It doesn't need to turn. It will drive straight to Berlin." Armament for the behemoth included three turrets. Two of the turrets carried 76.2mm cannons. The central turret is equipped with 156mm cannons, similarly to those carried on Russian battleships at the time. Secondary armament included smaller turrets, 44 and 12mm cannons and autocannons. Although unclear, the purpose of the secondary turrets could have been for anti-aircraft reasons. In December 1941, the first prototype was finished and immediately sent to the defense of Moscow, at that time on the brink of collapse under the German Blitzkrieg. The first prototype allegedly met its end when the rear turret inadvertently fired upon the centered main turret, igniting the ammunition stored in that location. The second prototype was completed in January 1942 and sent to the Leningrad front. The second prototype had upgrades upon the first, such as indication mechanisms to indicate when the turrets were aiming at other turrets on the tank and safeguards to prevent them from firing upon those areas. The upgrades, however, proved fruitless when the super tank met its end when it cracked in half while crossing a ravine. The hull of the tank was not able to sustain the weight of the center turret. That year, a third prototype was created and again sent to the Leningrad front with major hull strengthening upgrades. This prototype did show some success and potential after news that it had shot down three German aircraft. After firing all three turrets onto a German tank position, however, the entire land battleship toppled onto its side from the immense recoil. Continued failures such as these forced Stalin to cancel the project, and instead focused on mass production of the smaller but deadly T-34 tanks, which ultimately proved to be a war-winning decision for the Russians. Germany continued to experiment with ever bigger tanks, but ultimately was overcome by the never-ending wave of Russian armor. No photographic evidence exists of the original prototypes in action nor the remains. It has led some to believe that the land battleship never existed at all and was merely a story to spread insight via into German invading forces. Another explanation is that it was purely an aspiration of Stalin himself. Both Stalin and Hitler had the common belief that giant behemoth tanks would be the future of tank warfare and invaluable to the war effort itself.